The affirmative team's plan to raise the minimum wage to $10.10 an hour is in itself flawed. The change is far too abrupt and does not give businesses enough time to adjust to the change. A $3 raise in wages so suddenly is a big leap. According to an article written by Owen E. Richardson IV, wrote for cron.com, when the government mandates that small businesses must pay employees more, all wages must relatively rise as skilled and experienced workers become more valuable. Consequently, small businesses must either downsize their workforces, initiate hiring freezes, reduce employee hours and or benefits. By extension, a raise in the minimum wage also forces small businesses to move operating dollars away from expansion and inventory. From this, we can extract that businesses are unable to grow and create more jobs due to the redirection of funds to the new wages that have suddenly been dropped on them. Moving on to my next point, the affirmative team believes that raising the minimum wage will reduce crime. It will, in fact, do the opposite. There is evidence linking minimum wage increases to a rise in teenage crime from Bruce Bartlett, former domestic policy advisor to Ronald Reagan and Treasury official under George H.W. Bush. It is important to understand that the impact of the minimum wage is not uniform. For 98.2% of wage and salary workers in the U.S., there is no impact at all. Because they either already earn more than the minimum or not covered by it. However, for teenagers working in low-wage industries, those without skills, members of minority groups, and those living in areas of the country where wages tend to be lower, the impact can be severe. This is why, historically, economists have always found the primary impact of minimum wage has been on minority teenagers. Bartlett continues, when people cannot get legitimate jobs, it is not surprising that they turn to crime and the underground economy. Studies by Masanori Hashimoto of Ohio State University and Ladd Phillips of the University of California, Santa Barbara, both show that increases of employment show that increases in the minimum wage increase teenage crime. And a study by William Baranek of the University of Georgia found that the minimum wage increases employment of illegal aliens who are unlikely to report any violations of the Fair Labor Standards Act to the Department of Labor. From this, we can conclude that with a higher minimum wage, comes less employment and education with more crime. By raising the minimum wage, the affirmative team may create more jobs in the short term, but will deplete jobs in the long term. The affirmative plan to raise the minimum wage to $10.10 an hour disincentivizes the pursuit of higher education because what's the point? The wages are already high, so. To paraphrase something Richard Kirkham, whom we all know and love, said in April 2017, one of the unintended side effects of a higher minimum wage is that fewer people go to school. This devalues the American worker. When more people join the labor force without going to school, an unskilled workforce is created, essentially forcing employers to automation because paying such high wages for low-skilled work is not worth it in their eyes. And honestly, I can't blame them. According to Ed Renzi, former CEO and president of McDonald's. It's not just McDonald's that has embraced job-replacing technology. Numerous restaurants have looked to computer tablets as a solution for rising labor costs that don't adversely impact the customer's experience. Pizza, a fully automated restaurant concept, now has 5 locations, all in cities that or states that have embraced a high minimum wage. And in a scene stolen from the Jetsons, the Starship delivery robot is now navigating the streets of San Francisco with groceries and other consumer goods. The company's founder has pointed to a rising minimum wage as a key factor driving the growth of his automated delivery business. I mean, there's an automatic like self-service kiosk in McDonald's like down the street. So I mean, who knows how many jobs that can replace. When automation takes over the very workers, minimum wage increase is meant to benefit. Those workers will find themselves out of a job and out of prospects due to their lack of skill and education. So to recap, businesses are due to the fact that new wages have been like suddenly dropped on them, and they are unable to expand or grow their business. Minimum wage leads to crime and less education, and jobs are cut short because employers are looking to other sources of service. Thank you.